Welcome to EPG Pathshala. This is Dr. Ankush Ambarda from Department of Tourism and Rural Management, Kurukshetra University, Kurukshetra. Today, I'll be taking up a topic from the subject Tourism and Hospitality, and the subject is Component of Tourism. Completing this unit, we'll be able to understand the tourism and its purpose, types of components, parameters, and role of components in tourism growth, the key factors of components of tourism. Well, tourism is one such action in which every one of us have taken part, eventually of time. The school excursion to the neighborhood exhibition hall, or the day cookout to the vital landmark or waterfall, stop close to your city, or trek to a position of religious significance, all these are a piece of greater range of tourism. You may likewise recall the yearly outing back to your grandparents living in another city, or family getaway to new goals, or possibly simplifying investigating new places of enthusiasm for urban areas or places close to the place where you grew up. The joy and fervor of encountering another goal is the thing that makes tourism action such a prominent movement. In spite of the fact that tourism action is regularly alluded to as the action of going to places for delight, it likewise includes the travel attempted with the end goal of exchange or business. It is a movement which is undertaken by people, or gathering of people, which includes dislodging from their standard conditions, that is living arrangements or private districts. This development of individuals with the end goal of amusement or business shapes the base of the tourism part or the matter of tourism. Numerous faculty from different industry, for example, aircraft, railroads, convenience and others meet up, make our visit a casual and essential issue. This unit will introduce to the largest employment generating, vast and fast growing industry of tourism, an industry that thrives on people who form the core of the industry. Now, defining term tourism, it is an all-around recorded certainly that people have dependably been voyaging, either looking for nourishment, heaven and security, or for exchange. Throughout the hundreds of years, the action of travel has changed to the demonstration of tourism, and in this way draw the insulination to characterize tourism. One may pose the inquiry, why do we have to characterize tourism? Don't we as a whole comprehend tourism movement? Why does everybody want to characterize everything and top off books upon books with definitions? Indeed, to answer these inquiries, we need to comprehend the mind-boggling nature of the tourism movement. As saw by Lit J in 1989, tourism represents the single biggest quiet development of individual crosswise over social limits of the world. This implies tourism includes a considerable measure of development of individuals both inside and crosswise over universal limits. As you know, these developments are going prompts financial advantages to all concerned. To investigation and keep all records of these advantages of tourism, it ends up plainly imperative to distinguish and characterize tourism and also the members of movement, that is sightseers. Tourism, the origin of this word itself is a research. According to a tourism researcher, Theobald, it has been watched that the meaning of tourism fluctuates from source to source. There is no evident accord with respect to the meaning of tourism. Just a couple of usually alluded definitions are said in this unit. Tourism is characterized as the total of the marvel and connections emerging from the travel and remain of non-occupants insofar as they don't prompt changeless living arrangements and are not associated with any gaining movement. This definition, figured by Swiss professor Hanziker and Kraft in 1939, was acknowledged by the International Association of Scientific Experts in Tourism, WEST, and it is by the wide margin the most well-known definitions among everyone of the meanings of tourism. Matheson and Wall, 1982, created a good working definition of tourism as the temporary movement of people to destinations outside their normal places of work and residence. The activities undertaken during their stay in those destinations and the facilities created to cater to their needs. United Nations World Tourism Organization has defined tourism as It comprises the activities of persons traveling to and staying in places outside their unusual environment for not more than one consecutive year for leisure, business, and other purposes not related to exercise of an activity remunerated from within the place visited. UNWTO further states that tourism is different from travel. In order for tourism to happen, there must be a displacement. An individual has to travel using any type of means of transportation. He or she might even travel on foot. Nowadays, it is often the case for poorer societies and happens even in more developed ones and concerns pilgrims, hikers. But all travel is not tourism. Three criteria are used simultaneously in order to characterize a trip as a belonging to tourism. The three criteria are that the displacement must be such as, first, it includes an uprooting outside the standard condition. This term is of most extreme significance and will be talked about later on. Second type of reason, the travel must happen for any reason, not quite the same as being compensated from inside the place went to. As far as possible, where tourism was limited to amusement and seeing family and companions, are currently extended to incorporate an immense range of purpose. Third, duration. Just a maximal span is said not an insignificant. Tourism relocation can be with or without an overnight remain. Thus, we know now that all tourism activity involves travel, but all travel do not mean tourism. Purpose of tourism. We have pursued in history that people have been going since the antiquated circumstances looking for situants, asylum, security, and after that for exchange. The inclination to travel and find new places has remained with us. However, the reason for these trips has changed. Motivation behind tourism here implies that essential reason because of which a vacationer has gone on an outing. Without this reason, visitor would not take the visit. In the present day times, the motivation behind travel can be characterized under one of the accompanying headings. First is leisure, recreation, holiday, health, study, religion, sports, and so on. Business, family mission, meetings. Let us explore these purposes of travel and understand their role as purpose of tourism. Leisure. It is the available time one has after all the day-by-day booked exercises have been dealt with. A few people get a kick out of the chance to pursue as a relaxation action, while some take up moving and their individual who go climbing as a recreation action. Individuals likewise pair available time to take visits or go on getaways. The motivation behind these treks change and can be arranged according to the goal or movement included. Just a couple of such reasons for tourism are recorded beneath. Recreation. The annual vacation or the weekend gateway for some relaxation and fun activity is one of the primary purposes for tourism. It could be a long break away or a small trip to a nearby destination. Holiday. A unique goal or site pulls in us to visit the goal for an occasion. It is likewise conceivable that the goal may be giving us a chance to partake in a movement that is novel to that goal. For example, snorkeling is the coral reef's landmark of significance, or even a creature or plant species one of a kind to a goal gives occasion produces a reason for going by one specific goal over others. Health. A change of climate often recommended by doctors for the reoperation of health leads to a trip outside the usual place of residence. Lately, it has also been observed that one travels not only to a different city but also to other country for the purpose of medical treatment. These all add up as a purpose for tourism. Education. Education, especially higher education, is reason for traveling out of the city of residence to another. Although, at times, for a student, the period of stay in the new city exceeds 1 year, still it is considered as educational tourism as long as it is not related to the exercise of any activity remunerated from within the place visited, that is, place of education. Religion. Tourism for the purpose of religion, belief, is one of the oldest known purposes of tourism. People travel for the purpose of pilgrimage, for example, Hajj, Char Dham Yatra, fulfilling certain promises to deities as well as for some special religious functions or events such as Kumbh Mela and so on. Sports. Sporting events attract fans and spectators from across the globe, especially international sporting events that occur after interval like Cricket World Cup or the Olympic Games and so on. Sporting events always see a lot of tourists, both in the form of spectators as well as participants and the families. No wonder there is a rush to host such international sporting events, business meetings, etc. It is not only for the purpose of leisure that one participates in tourism activities. At times, one participates in tourism activities out of necessity. Five such purposes are given below. Business. A business will have to go on a tour out of necessity, whether to buy or to sell the product. Meeting. An outstation meeting with clients will necessitate one to travel to another city or country. Family. A birth, wedding, or even a funeral in the family and extended family means going on trip. The commonly used terminology here is VFR, that is visiting family, friends and relatives. Now that you are familiar with the importance of purpose in tourism, let us discuss what else comprises and promotes tourism. Now that you are familiar with the importance of purpose in tourism, let us discuss what else comprises and promotes tourism. Now, components of tourism. Specialist co-ops offer the fundamental part of the tourism business. They comprise of suppliers of transportation, convenience and pleasantries. Tourism is a mind-boggling business that relies upon the linkage of these segments. Every go-between component assumes an essential part in the system of tourism business. In this manner, the segment of tourism and its frameworks, procedures, relationships and results are concentrated to comprehend the parts and capacities. Tourism is made to do with framework approach, whose point is to streamline the complexities of tourism exercises into various little parts. These parts are between related with the framework way to deal with concrete or alternate points of view of tourism. Tourism parts are what make the tourism business work the way it does, and without these segments, tourism industry will stop to exist or fall flat. Parts in layman's term allude to the instrument with the assistance of which the hardware of tourism works. These segments of tourism are generally alluded to as the A's of tourism, on occasion four A's of tourism. The first A is attraction. It alludes to the elements of goal that pulls or draws in sightseers to a goal is ordinarily known as tourist attractions. These attractions can be nature-based, for example, a national park, a historical monument, theme stop, climate, an area of the goal, for example, a hill station or even an occasion, for example, Cannes Film Festival. The world popular Disneyland, Disney World in the US, the Louvre Museum and Eiffel Tower in Paris, the Hermitage in St. Petersburg, the Pyramid in Egypt, the Great Wall of China, the Inclining Tower of Pisa in Italy, and the Taj Mahal in India are prime goals for travelers everywhere throughout the world. The attractions of a goal legitimates its fame among voyagers. Second is accessibility. It is one of the most organized recreation sector that have become prominent in the recent past. Air transport consists of both scheduled and non-scheduled charter services. Road and rail transportation are included under surface transportation. Inland water transport includes navigation in inland water bodies such as river, lakes, etc. Infrastructure or maritime transportation includes cruises, ships, ports. Other methods of transportation incorporates walker travel, strolling, bicycling, and seat riding. Transportation on horses is incapable in uneven ranges where customary methods of transportation are not created. A goal can be on the highest point of a slope, wonderful atmosphere with ancient landmarks and remnants. The goal may even gloat of some delightful waterfalls, but say disagreeably among the voyagers as there are no streets or rails or air terminals. This implies, regardless of the possibility that a goal has attraction to pull sightseers, it may even now be disliked as it is not associated as far as transportation. As the goal is not available, openness to a goal or vacation spot will find out it notoriously among the travelers. Next is accommodation. Once the visitor has reached to the destination, the next requirement of the visitor is the right kind of accommodation according to his or her pocket and at the same time meeting the expectations of the guests. Hence, this is the place of stay and rest for the visitors. Settlement is another critical segment of tourism business. Since voyagers require boarding and cabin at their place of visit, a traveler goal must give boarding and hotel to help tourism. A goal with fascination and openness will get voyagers, yet visitors need a place to eat, shop and remain overnight to add to the economy of the goal. Accommodation can range from low to extreme high tariff according to the standards and facilities available in the properties. In India, accommodation can range from dharamshalas to a 5-star category hotels. Next is amenities. Luxuries at a visitor spot incorporate all offices that a vacationer needs at a goal. These are fundamental offices given to the visitors, for example, medicinal guide, remote cash, trade, well-being and security, corresponding offices and so on. The luxuries give make the things simpler to the vacationer in his or her new condition. In this way, the conveniences accessible to a traveler that will help keep up the prominence of a goal among sightseers. The accommodation sector includes popular hotel brands such as Hilton, Marriott, Best Western, Taj, Welcome Group, ITDC, etc. The food service sector includes a range of independent and chain restaurants, world-famous fast food chains such as McDonald's, Pizza Hut, Kentucky Fried Chicken, Burger King, TJ Fridays, so on and so forth, and have spread their network in major cities across the continent. Event business. The event sector involves professional bodies that organize, promote, and manage national and international events that are largest gatherings or congregations of people at one place. The Olympic Games, the Soccer World Cup, the Cricket World Cup, IPL, BPL, EPL, and Wimbledon tennis are some of the national and international events that entice people all over the world. Not only sports, there are other international and national events of religious, social, political, and trade interests of business and promotional types that attract people. The infrastructure required for the events include a convention center, intercity and intra-city transportation, hotels, food and beverage services, and convention planners. Interrelationship of tourism developments. Locals. Modern tourism planning starts with an understanding of the needs and demands of the locals and facilities available at the destinations. Tourism as an economic activity should be for the locals, by the locals, and of the locals. This is the reason why much importance is given to people initiated tourism than to tourism in which people only participate. The role of the local is important for two reasons. They should be first to enjoy the benefit of an economic activity for the ultimate impact of tourism that fall on the local environment. Opportunity should be given to the locals for initiating development, for executing policy decisions, and for managing tourism services in a sustainable way. Tourist. Tourists are of course an integral part of tourism business at any tourist destination. They are the ultimate consumers of service. The success of any tourist destination depends on a carefully made plan that is executed by efficient and experienced policy makers and planners. The execution of a well plan requires a comprehensive understanding about tourists' motivation and factors influencing their choice of destination and selection of their mode of travel. Natural environment and resources. Natural resources are at the core of tourism development. It is the principal appeal of a destination that acts as a pull factor for tourists to plan a visit. Though cataloging and analysis of natural resources is difficult, they may be broadly classified into physiographic, nature and appearance of landscape, climate, people, infrastructure. The destination becomes popular only when the infrastructure of the destination is up to the mark. The present world requires to be catered with the best amenities, services and facilities. The public and private sectors together can provide the right kind of infrastructure required. The advancement of foundation and tourism improvement are interrelated. Tourism can add to general financial advancements through the arrangement of streets, fountains, parks, fumed and treated water supplies, transfers and reusing and sewage treatments. Streets produced for tourism give chances to exchange, and new streets open to enhance exchange additionally bring tourism openings on the off chance that they open access to tourism assets. New financial passage advancement extends regularly make tourism improvements open doors for neighborhood groups, notwithstanding enhancing exchange linkages. These office upgrade open doors for different types of neighborhood financial advancements, yet more should be possible at the nearby and national level to boost those advantages, especially when new tasks are authorized. It is convincible to boost the arranging increase though suitable approaches by government and tourism organizers. The correct arrangement, the correct way will empower nearby financial advancement and advantage poor people. Now to summarize the unit, this unit has introduced component of tourism and have learned to define tourism as well as tourist and its purpose. This unit helps to understand various components of tourism and the introduction of component of tourism, particularly 4 A's of tourism, that is attraction, accessibility, accommodation, NC services was offered for your information. It has introduced you to the forms of tourism as well as given you an opportunity to learn about the parameters and role of component in tourism growth. This unit only gives a glimpse of the key factors of components of tourism and interrelationship of tourism development. Thank you for watching EPG Parshala. This was Dr. Ankush Ambarda from Kurukshetra University.